various charity organizations, including Islamic Relief. So it's my pleasure to welcome Sister Rilla Khan.
I ask myself how this stage came to be, how there is no escape, no where to flee, irritation beyond conceptuality and falsehood and deception beyond fantasy. What has become this notion of identity where it's impossible to find out the reality about hope and truth and victory? And it bothers me, cringing my veins, irrationality, the impulses fueling flames from frustration to trying to figure out this game, trying to figure out this illusion of these false claims of how and what we're supposed to be. Copying the media's perception of luxury and imitating Hollywood's depiction of beauty. So here's a question. Where do you belong? Who are you, and how do you go along with the image that society has given you, not the identity of your own? You're recognized by your achievements and accomplishments, not your own quality and tone of your spirituality and the very existence that you breathe and the very reality of the blood that's pumped through your body with every heartbeat. All these emotions and feelings that cannot be seen or touched or felt by anyone indeed except you and yourself only. So, who are you? Or rather, I should ask, what are you? What am I? How much of me is just a lie, just a sugar-coated image for me to pass by in this narcotic and psychotic world for which we all die? Die dreaming and depriving ourselves of this false hope that we're all living fairy tales with no problems to cope, falling into this deception of life of lusting over a slope, where once you reach the top, you know that you're bound to fall back down, and only then do you realize that it's your end of time to shine in that crown, and it might be too late by then to know that you should have gone around the illusions of this world that can only lead to frowns. Yet, it still has a billion followers all headed towards the ground. It's more striking than thunder, yet not even worth a pound. An identity crisis. Suddenly you realize you're all fake, priceless, designed by the media and ranked by the careless to whom you're just a number. And no, they don't care regardless of who you are and what you are as long as your brain lives to be entangling yourself in their trap and at the end feeling helpless. So I come back to my question, what are you? I start off by saying Bismillah, but do I even know what it means? I greet you by saying salam, but do I even know its degree? I am told that I'm free, but yet enslaved by the media and MNCs. I am told that I'm empowered, but always limited by these invisible boundaries just because of the way I look, being a hijabi, clashing against this glass ceiling above me through which I can see clearly this delusion, fogged, mystifying illusion of reality. And I am told that this is a land of opportunity, yet opportunity from me flees. I am told I'm unique, but when I present the difference, no one agrees. I'm told I have the freedom of expression, but when I wear the hijab, they say it's oppression. But oppression to me is the enforcement of secularization, where men and women both have lost their dignity and self-freedom to be who they want or what they want without any repercussions, having all the fame and glamour only if they limit their selections of how they live their lives, dress, eat, and yes, it's a source of depression, and it's sad to say how many people commit suicide because they cannot fit into this collection of gruesome, enslaving, engraving repressions. And then I am told that men of my kind define suppression, but it's not them who have the highest rate of domestic violence and aggression. I see all around me disgusting lies and accusations of Muslim being fundamental supporters of terrorism. But it's sad that most people do not even know the true definition of Islam or what it means to be Muslim or terrorism. So let me take a moment to clarify and define them for you. Islam is a word of peace, a message of love, truthfulness, and unity, and a Muslim is a follower of that message of love, peace, unity, tranquility. Whereas a terrorist is defined as someone who terrorizes, someone who is an imminent threat to one's life and security, causing panic to arise in their hearts and security and families and villages. No compromises, whether an adult or child, the threat doesn't bother to categorize it. So now, looking at the world around you, who is the real terrorist? In what world is a helpless mother or a child a threat to a soldier? Thousands and thousands of our Muslim brothers and sisters die every minute from a bullet or a bomb or an attack by strong forces. They're so helpless and weak and have no powerful sources to help them because we're too busy with our own lives. No remorse is shown by our ummah, which is why we're so broken. Just like a plant's growing mechanism, its photosynthesis, the unity of this ummah is crucial to finish for successful finishes of war, terror, abuse, and the elimination of these false images of terrorizing, crucifying, obnoxiously lying Muslims of all ages. But crime and sorrow sell. People are more interested in how you fell and how we're all settled victims. They're forcing us to sell ourselves, our bodies, our labor for them to succeed and tell the world of how powerful they are because of their so-called skills. And it's a known fact that there's widespread corruption, hatred, and envy. Those you love are running away from you speedily, and you push away those who love you unconditionally. We are shaped to run after these figures freely, figures who don't even know or care about our existence, really. Narcissistic, dominating, ruthless personalities who we dream to be, implying it to our own realities. And this is why my role model is the best of all mankind. His love for his people does not consist of words to be defined. He cared for his people even though they were in decline of his preaching and teachings of the One Divine. And the miracle he was given by the One who could not be refined, nor surpassed, nor concluded, nor redefined. Because it was, is, and always will be the Word of God. The Quran, this blessing to mankind for all people all abroad. A human's best friend to be away from deception, lies, greed, and fraud, and being as firm as a metal rod. And then I am told that they feel sorry for me for being forced to follow this regulation, but to me, my identity of a Muslimah is of liberation, a true meaning of comfort, peace, patience of consideration, a chance for me to be myself without any humiliating, dehumanizing limitations. I wear the hijab for my own representation, and Muslim men grow their beards for as their hijab, no revolution, because it shows the beauty and peace from within, and it's not a means of fake double standardizations. But this may seem odd to someone who's been hypnotized, brainwashed to believe that Muslims are born to terrorize, and thus society should always have a watchful eye to defeat this unknown threat and victimize us and our families, pushing us to criticize our very own values and beliefs and to individualize. But even after all that, I'm a Muslim and I'm proud, and I stand here announcing my message out loud that I love mankind for his sake and for his sake aloud. But if this seems strange, then I must say that I am a stranger. So if you're a stranger too, then glad tidings to the stranger, because the Prophet said that you're in no danger. A mu'min in this world is just a prisoner, an effective member of society, an active participant and listener, fulfilling their jobs required and still having religion by their side for peace, comfort, and intuition. This beautiful religion of Islam, permitting us with what's okay and helping us to stay away from harm, guiding us to success and ways to earn, ways for us to follow and be content and learn, and to lead us to the path to Jannah, where we will no longer be interned, no longer be imprisoned, inactivated, incapacitated souls in our own bodies, but rather showered with immense and countless blessings and commodities to forever live in peace, happiness, and quality. This is Islam, brothers and sisters. The rest to our hearts, the fuel of our spirits for satisfaction and peace start, the food for our thought, the breath for our lungs, the blood of our veins, our bodies are. So internalize this beautiful message of Islam and see the peace and tranquility that you will feel shortly. And have a true and pure identity with a successful life that you will live purposefully, because time is ticking and passing quickly and death is winning this race against you speedily. So step up to fight against for your own victory in this world and the hereafter. Be a witness of your own defeat against your deceiving, self-incriminating desires indeed. And remember, always remember that Allah is always there for you. So never lose hope, because inshallah, He will always help you through your problems and struggles and guide you through these rough times. And may He shower His mercy and blessings on each and every one of you. Ameen. Jazakallah.